So I'm going to be playing a clip of a wicked false teacher. I mean, an absolutely wicked false teacher, basically agreeing to turn his church into a drug farm in order to attract black young men to his church. Listen, there was a time when even false teachers knew not to say certain things because they knew that the people listening would know that it was absolutely ridiculous. But those days are gone. Those days are long gone. And this is what we have now.
And a lot of churches are just recycling people from other churches. That's not who I'm after. I'm looking for people that smell like weed. I'm at their place, Rashawn. New Birth is the largest land-owning black church in America.
Wow.
And so my position to my deacons is, why aren't we not raising cannabis? I'll be able to bring in black males. They're able to do it legally.
Mm.
I'm teaching them farming.
Oh, my God.
I'm helping them to enhance the ecosystem. This is the kind of conversation. So if the guy, black boy in Bankhead, said, they growing weed at the church, where do I join?
Yes.
I don't need no pamphlet for him.
Yeah. Right, right.
He coming in. And that's the group that I'm going after.
Yeah. That's different.
Yeah.
See, one of the things that evangelism eventually reveals to you after you've shared the gospel with enough people, family members, coworkers, people out in public, what you eventually realize is that the preaching of the gospel is nothing more than a fool's errand apart from the grace and power of God. Natural sinners are dead, literally dead. There is nothing you can do to make God look attractive enough to an unconverted sinner that will make them want God. There is nothing you can do. Okay. But there is something you can do. Let's share the gospel. What you will do by becoming more like the world to attract those in the world is heap more and more condemnation upon your head for the day of judgment. Okay. And as a false teacher, your suffering in hell will be more than that of the average sinner who dies in their sins. This is not a game. Listen, I fear more for false teachers than I do for anyone on the day of judgment. But understand this, that false teacher, okay, that false teacher that you just heard, he is doing the will of God. God will get glory from false teachers. For God has mercy on some, and he chooses to harden others. But in all of that, it's all of God. See, God uses false teachers and false churches to draw sinners away from the true bride of Christ, to pull them away so that the true bride looks different, looks strange. Why is it that when I was first converted, someone told me that I resembled that of a cultist? Okay, because true Christianity is not normal, even amongst those that profess to be of God. You will never make God look attractive enough to lost sinners. Okay, that's not your goal. What your goal is to make the preaching of the word of God, God's gospel, known. Okay, that's your goal. Okay, your goal is to honor your Lord and Savior by exhorting his gospel message. And then by faith, trusting in his sovereign decree to do what he pleases with it. Okay, this isn't about you. It's about God. Yea, fool, do you really think the God of the heavens and the earth, the creator God that is perfectly sustaining the universe effortlessly, okay, effortlessly, needs you to add something to his gospel to make it more beautiful or appealing? The only thing this false teacher has revealed is what he is not, and that's a Christian. When you truly fear God, okay, when you truly fear God, you stop desiring the eyes and attention of the world. That's why, to those of you who call yourselves Christian on this channel, tell me about your time alone when no one else is around and only God can see. What are you doing? What does your devotional life look like? That will tell me what you truly are. The man that gets up in the wee hours of the morning while everyone else in the house is asleep because he needs his time alone with his God. He only desires his Lord's eyes upon him. That's the man. That's the man that won't compromise or change to attract the world.